So great question. This is a true question. I find spiritual work difficult, but do like Facebook. I really did get that one. Spiritual work is boring. Well, who is it boring for? Well, of course, it's boring for the ego. The ego loves to be entertained. And spiritual work is destroying the ego. So the ego likes short-term gain, long-term pain. So if I could spend 10 hours on binging on Facebook for today and debating on Facebook, I mean, the ego, of course, is like a little kid. You know, 10 hours of Facebook today in bed with a plate of chips. Sounds great. But, you know, after 3 or 4 days of that, you know, you're spiritually and physically disconnected. And life feels awful. And then your ego is going to tell you, well, you know, you feel awful. Why don't you just watch even more Facebook or do more Facebook and have a big pizza instead? That's the only way out of this. So short term is good. So spiritual work is boring. Well, one way to look at it is when you sit down to do some spiritual work, ask yourself, is it my spirit that's bored or is it my ego that is bored? So what's the answer to that question? And then do what you think is the right thing, because obviously your ego wants ice cream, it wants Facebook, it wants a good sort of drama on TV. And the idea of meditating and being still is boring to your ego. It's to your inner kid, finds it boring. But, you know, I guess it's the spinach, you know, eat your spinach. That's probably not a good metaphor, is it really? That's probably put people off spiritual work. But the thing is, why don't you just tell your inner ego that if I sit still and go, I'll tell you a good way, boredom. Okay, what's the meaning of boredom and who's bored? Well, your ego's bored. Your ego wants the short-term payoff. So why don't you when you think spiritual work is boring and you'd rather want to do Facebook or something else, why don't you look at it like it's growing your spiritual muscles? Maybe that's not a good one. What about getting back to your spiritual highs when everything flows and life seems wonderful? So maybe that could entice you to sit down for 10 minutes and try and be still and be with yourself and see what's coming up for you, your feelings, your thoughts. And just allow sort of divinity to come in and give you what it needs, the spiritual nourishment, by releasing any feelings, getting in touch with any deeper stuff that you need to get in touch with rather than do the Facebook. So that's exciting. What about before you do your spiritual work, remembering being in high spiritual fields where everything flowed by, life was just joyous in every moment and everything came your way? And how do you feel after like several days of looking at Facebook and debating? How do you feel after that? So all of those things might, you know, if I'm making this video to be helpful, then why don't you see the long-term payoff of sitting with yourself and doing the spiritual work? I do think of all the things in life to do, having a regular spiritual practice is the best thing you can do for yourself. And most people who've got any kind of spiritual recovery do daily spiritual practice. What I would say in terms of daily spiritual practice, making spiritual practice fun. How do you make spiritual practice fun? Okay, well, I think one of the things, you know, the thing with Course in Miracles is you have to see through the illusions of the ego to see the truth. You can also pray for a miracle to see this in truth. The truth of the matter is, if you want, does fun come from outside things, or is true everlasting fun coming from the inside? Okay, so all right, I understand. You know, which is more fun, Facebook or sitting with yourself quietly and trying to connect to a higher power? Okay, so you got to sort of see everything your ego comes up with through the filters of, is it true or not? Is it an illusion or is this a red herring? So the truth is, I mean, with myself, I mean, ask me if I had to have a conversation with my ego, like, do I want fun to be an inside job? so I can be having fun in this moment because I'm present, I'm in the moment, I'm in the now. I'm connected to God, which means that the light, the sunlight of the spirit is inside. My fun is in every moment, irrespective of what's happening in the world. Or do I want my fun to be a dependency on an activity or a thing or a person which makes me feel fun? Because which would I rather have? Would I rather have endless fun for the rest of my life, which means fun comes from the now, fun comes from inside of me, the love of God? Or do I want fun to be associated with whether Facebook, whether I can get to Facebook right now? So which fun do I want? Okay, because let's, maybe sometimes the ego is very clever. So it says, I want fun now. And fun can be Facebook or can be donuts or it can be whatever it is. But if I choose fun from an outside thing, which is passing, transitory, a donut or a social media platform, then I'm going to be a dependent on, what if Facebook suddenly goes into bankruptcy and the website goes down or it's hacked down and there's no Facebook for a month? Then my fun is vulnerable. I'll go into grief because I'm having fun on something which cannot be with me always. So do I want my fun? So we're using the word fun and boredom because actually every spiritual seeker has pain with these two things. Spiritual work is boring. I want my fun now. Yeah, so we all identify. I want my fun now. But doing spiritual work is stripping illusions, you know, and seeing them in truth. So any fun that I try and get from something outside of myself has the risk of making me dependent on it for fun. And also another thing, anyone who's got addiction problems knows, the fun, when you make something outside of yourself your fun, is that it eventually wears off and stops working. I had that with donuts, you know, you can't have endless fun with donuts, they stop working eventually. That is quite funny when it's almost killing you. But can you have fun being present? Can you have fun when you're in the eternal now? Can you have fun in what I call fields of divine flow? Well, you know, fun actually becomes a thing of just being alive, just being present. There's equal fun. Here's the problem the ego doesn't like. There's equal fun in the park as there is in the toilet, as there is at work, as there is whatever's happening in the world. I mean, the fun is like constant. And ego fun is like fun when I'm with a person, when I'm looking at Facebook and things. So that's how I'm going to answer it. Try and see the truth when your ego tells you it wants fun now. So it's a bit more of an inner thing. But I think if you listen to this video, whenever you want to have fun, it might be useful. I'll stop there.